John, that there is more hand passing nowadays. Do the figures back that up?
Yeah, most certainly. It's a very different animal now, Gaelic football, than it was a few generations ago. If you just take as a sort of an example, the 76 All-Ireland final, Mick will know all about that, Kerry in Dublin. That day, 36% of the passes that were attempted were hand passes. Fast forward then to 2010, there was a survey done in the Ulster Championship of 8 matches, and the percentage of hand passes had actually gone up to 63%, which is, you know, basically flipped all around. Yeah. And then to bring it forward to its most extreme example was last year's All-Ireland semi-final, Donegal and Dublin. And Donegal, actually 87% of their attempted passes were hand passes. But, I mean, they were pilloried for that, but every county has undergone the same transition. Even Kerry, who had been the original exponents of catch-and-kick football, in last year's Munster final, they only kicked 9 passes further than 25 yards, which is startling, really.
It is startling. Danny, as a current intercounty footballer, is there too much hand passing in the game?
Well, I suppose you see the modern teams now, and they're really reflective of the coaching and the management that's actually going on, and who is actually coaching and managing. So I suppose in light of that, there is too much hand passing in our opinion. We were very traditionalist and down, in that we like a nice brand of open and fluent football. And, you know, it is difficult when you come up against teams that are playing the packed defences. And I suppose you have to look at what point you substitute results for obviously something that's a lot better to watch. But, you know, it's very, very much like a results game now, and hard and fair like any Premiership soccer team. So managers will do whatever they have to win games.
But Danny, are players afraid to kick long sometimes?
In certain cases there is a fear there among a vast majority of players to kick the ball. As well as that, I question how much of the coaching goes on in that, how many games, short-sighted games in training, etc., etc. So, you know, are there kick passing drills going into training? Is the coaching correct, even at the underage levels? And are people taught to kick properly, you know? So,
Mikko, as Danny says there about coaching and coaches, why do they favour a more hand-passing game now?
Well, I'd say the biggest problem that in the game at the present time is all the forwards are back in defence. So when the ball is won at half-back or won by a forward, they look up and there's nobody there to play the ball to. Mm. I think that's the biggest problem. But the team, I think, that will come up with good hitmen inside. And I think Donegal are changing to a degree this year with McFadden and Murphy and the other corner forward they have there. They're three good players. And I think if you get the ball in quick and fast to players of that calibre, I think scores will come. But yes, the hand passing maybe is overdone. But that's the big reason for it. We're imitating soccer more than anything, I think. You know, the only thing that we haven't got in our game at the moment is the offside rule. Yeah. So if that was brought in, maybe it might tidy up the game a little bit better than it is at the moment.
I think the danger actually is that, you know, good technical kickers are being coached out of the game because, as Danny was saying, maybe those drills aren't being done anymore. Mm. And if you watch inter-county game now, when a player gets the ball in the middle third of the field, not so much anymore is instinct to look up and pick out a man for a pass. He's immediately looking to side or back, waiting for the runner to pop the pass. So it is getting to the stage where it's being coached out of the game.
And why has it evolved like this, John? What's the reason?
I think Danny hit the nail on the head when he said, you know, the hire and fire sort of mentality with coaches. Nowadays, if you're appointed an intercounty manager, you know you have 1 year to make a marker. If you don't, there's a good chance you won't be back. So your first goal is, okay, I need to make the quickest level of improvement possible. So the two things you get right, you get your defence right and you get ball retention right, because then you can't be, you know, as damaged as much yourself. Jim McGuinness went into Donegal last year, that's precisely what he did. He got them organised defensively. He said, we'll play cagey football, a low risk, hand passing. In the Ulster Championship 2 years ago, 94% of attempted hand passes were successful. So, you know,
you could quite easily have got to the All-Ireland final by playing that brand of football. It's the amazing part of it all, isn't it?
Mm. And are you a fan of that Donegal team and the style of football?
Well, I wasn't a fan of them last year, to be very honest, but I think they're playing a better brand of football this year. And if they continue to do that, they're quite capable of winning in All-Ireland. But there's a lot of Ulster teams up there thinking otherwise at the present time, including down here. Am I right? So it'll be an interesting year.
I think Ulster football has also it's become stereotypical in that I think a lot of people have said that Ulster football has really changed Gaelic football in general, and the intensity that Tyrone and Armagh brought to in the early 2000s. But I think you know, you see Kerry now, are they playing in the traditional Kerry way, or are they playing more defensive? And and to a certain extent, you have to suit your own traditions as a county. And I think Ulster gets a wee bit of a bad rap, to be honest.
Yeah, but Kerry are now, at the moment, if you watch all their play at the present time, it's solo, pass, where if you went back to the teams that I was in charge of, it was maybe a pass and a quick delivery. That don't seem to be there at the present time. But the team that will do that, there's no question or doubt about it, will have success in the future.
John Martin mentioned in that piece that we saw about rule changes. Would you be in favour of rule changes coming in, Danny, that would affect the hand pass?
Personally, I'm against tinkering with any more rule changes. I think the game is fast, and when it's played in the right manner and when it's coached in the right manner, there's no better game in the world, and it's exciting. But the problem is here that it's not being played in the correct manner. Now, I think the only way that the hand pass is going to destroy it, people start to walk away, and it's going to financially hurt the GAA. When that comes in, then they'll start making rule changes. Now, I don't know what the tendencies seem to be decent in Ulster, they seem to be up in current years. So
good crowd in Armagh.
And there was, and to be fair, the last few championship Ulster championship games have been good. So, you know, when people start walking with their feet, I think that's when the rule changes come in.
John, what do you think about rule changes? In relation to this,
it's hard to know what to do to solve the problem. I mean, if you limit the number of hand passes per game, the only way it would be possible to do that would be to say you can't have more than one hand pass. So you can't have two consecutive hand passes. Like if I hand pass you, you have to kick to someone else, because any more than that, the referee will not be able to keep track of it.
Yeah.
But then, you know, in that scenario, Mikko was saying to me earlier, if I hand pass you and you have to kick and you're suddenly surrounded, it looks very ugly if you're trying to somehow get a kick out there. It looks awkward.
Yeah.
And then the game becomes even more cluttered. I'd be for rule changes in general. I think there are ways to still improve the game. I think the clean pick up off the ground, using your toes, one.
That's a great idea. Yeah. Something I have recommended about 20 years ago. That should be part of our game. And the mark as well, I think. The mark should also be brought
in. So would you be in favour of rule changes in terms of the hand pass now, specifically?
No, I wouldn't, because where do you go from there? You know, unless you get a guy who could solo hop and he passes the ball, then it should be played by foot. But that's the only rule you could do.
Yeah.
But I think that would make a mess of the game, to be honest. You know, I wouldn't be in favour of changing it all. I think the games this year have been pretty good. Don't mind John Mahan.
I think one rule change.
He's entitled to his point of view,
course,
all right?
Of course, yeah.
He is, yeah, sure.
Yeah.
One rule change that actually might make a difference would be going to 13 a side, because you have more open space and it's easier to hit those angle balls, more space to kick into. And, you know, it might solve the problems too. Lots of clubs are struggling for
that. Would be a good idea. Tucking aside would be a big difference, all right.
I think a team needs to come along and win an All Ireland playing an open brand of football that's obviously pleasing to the public. Somebody needs to come and do that. And when that's done, people will, I think, like anything else, games will change.
I think to an extent Dublin did that, though. I mean, up to a point they hand passed, but most of their success was hitting those diagonal balls into their inside forwards. And I still think, you know, you can improve it to a certain point by playing the cagey game, but if you want to be All-Ireland champions, you have to have that element to your play.
OK, well, we'll see what the FTC say in time. Nice ideas, though, lads.